You can tell from the car that this is no ordinary bloke arriving for a day's work.
Morning, Australia. Leanne, could you bring the mail in? What time's the production meeting?
10:30.
Great. Everybody here?
Yes, Al.
Great.
John De Jong, better known as Johnny Young, Australia's answer to Cliff Richard in that he seems to go on forever and never gets any older, yeah, is starting another day.
Morning, everyone.
Good day, Johnny.
You're supposed to stand up when I get in.
Oh, sorry.
This is the side of Johnny that you don't often get to see.
For a long time, when show business was all that I had in my life, when it was the only thing that I did, I had everything. You know, I made a lot of money. I was very successful. I had all the things that people would say should make you happy, but it didn't make me happy. And then when I turned around the other way and said, well, instead of looking for happiness in there, I look for happiness in myself. When I found the happiness in myself, I started to enjoy my job again. It's really funny, but that's the way it worked. If you could plan it right.
So now he has interests in an FM radio station, in real estate, in his own production house, and of course in young talent time itself, of which he's executive producer. Now he doesn't just sit in the public limelight, he calls all the shots as well.
If you could plan it in such a way that you've got something else happening visually, for a few minutes in between each verse,
right,
then you've just got time to whip off one and put on the other.
Believe it or not, there is a private side to Johnny Young, although he keeps it well hidden. Perhaps that's the secret to his personal success, the fact that he knows where his boundaries lie. There are invisible boundaries that tell him when to give up the glamour life and get down to serious work, when to invest wisely instead of spending big, and where to place his private life and his family in the scheme of things. They come out well on top, although with incidents such as the John Lennon killing fresh in his memory, being a famous family man can hold its terrors.
I don't live in constant fear of it, but I am aware of it, and I take precautions, you know, to protect myself and my family from that, for sure, as a lot of people in show business do, and so they should. It's unfortunate, but that's the way it is. I live a title life. I have my work, and that's important to me. I enjoy it. I have a good time with it. And I have my family, and it's important to me in a different way. You know, I feel very responsible for my children and my wife. I like to look after them. I like them to be comfortable. I enjoy their company. It's not a paranoic thing of, you know, I must be with my children. It's just a natural thing. You know, I have a wife and I have a child and I had children, several, and I enjoy them.